Okay, next, I would like to welcome Murali Sundaram, Executive Director of BNI Chennai CBDA. She is the master, he is the national trainer for BNI India, is a happiness coach. And I would like to say one experience I had with him. I knew Murali Sundaram from 2014. I went for a program and I saw Murali Sundaram standing behind. And he's always smiling as in the same way, he's smiling in this photo. And I was wondering what this guy is doing. I went to Murali Sundaram and asked, what do you do? Then he said he's a happiness coach. I didn't take him serious at that moment. After that, after spending a couple of days, I came to realize he's an amazing person. He's really happy. Later, I got an opportunity from another event to meet her his daughter. And same way, his daughter is also very happy, very active, lot of stuff. So I understood how he groomed his daughter. Amazing person. The one forgettable moment for me was we went for a movie together. It was a Hindi movie. It was a very serious movie, and in between the movie, he keeps cracking joke, and I enjoyed his way of talk in between the movie more than the movie, and it was an amazing experience. Murali Sundaram is the person from whom you should learn how to be happy. I would say that. One thing I look into the speakers who come over here is, I only take speakers who have done it, lived it. And Murali Sundaram is one such a kind of person from whom I would like to learn how to be happy, and everyone should learn how to be happy. I welcome Murali Sundaram. Everyone, please type clap in the chat box for Murali Sundaram. Over to you, Murali.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thanks a lot. You can close the screen, Abhishek, so that I can just speak. Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, BNI. It's always morning in BNI. Thank you, Abhishek, for that amazing introduction. All of funny stuff. Thank you very much, guys, for investing your time in this Business Success Conference. I'm sure that each one of you are really learning something new. Yes or no? I think for the last 30 minutes, an amazing way of how we can learn to do business in a VUCA world from the army example. It's a fantastic, Abhishek. Amazing presentation you guys did. Fantastic. Awesome. Now, what am I going to do? I'm going to speak to you for 30 minutes. Probably before you guys go and hit the bed, I will quickly share with you how you can be happier more than ever now. Okay, because this is a situation. I saw many of your questions and you're asking, what will I do in this situation? Yes or no? I'm going to share with you some simple things of how you can be always happier than ever. Let the world may fall, let the heaven may fall, come what may, whatever happens. How can you be happy? How many of you in this room are really, really interested to learn how to be happy, come what may, whatever happens in your life? You can say yes in the chat box so that I know that you are in the right place at the right time. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much for that. Thank you. You know, this is, I'm going to keep it very simple and easier so that all of us can follow. Every time people read my name, happiness coach, they only ask me the first question, how the hell are you happy? Abhishek also said, now what do you do? Happiness. How are you happy is the question everyone asks. How to teach happiness is the second question they ask. Okay, let me be very honest. I cannot teach happiness to anyone. Okay, because no one can teach happiness to anyone. Because we are all born happy. Foundation of life itself is happiness only. So no one can teach happiness. Somewhere down the line, as we grew up in our life, we started attracting a lot of negative things and belief, and we became unhappy in our life. That's the reason I always say there are no keys of happiness in the world. There are only two keys of unhappiness in the world. If you can identify these two keys of unhappiness in the world, you can always become successful. You know, once I was entering a lift, and I was supposed to go to the 20th floor to my friend's house. One more friend came along with me. You know, he looked at me and said that, Murali, you are a happiness coach. How about you teaching me how to be happy within the lift hits the 20th floor? That means within 45 seconds, urgently, he wants to learn how to be happy. So I started laughing at him, and then I told him one technique in 15 seconds time. And after that, he was literally angry for the next 30 seconds until the lift locked. We entered into the friend's house. He kept his mouth shut. I can see the anger on his face. Then after that 1 week, this fellow didn't even speak to me. I was wondering, what did I do wrong in the lift? I just told him one technique. Why is he so angry? After 1 week, he called me and said that, Murali, I was thinking about your technique for the last 1 week. I want to prove you that your technique doesn't work. I said, okay, please go and practice. He said, I will practice it for 30 days. Then I will prove you that you are wrong. Whenever someone comes and tells a teacher that I'm going to practice what you taught me, the teacher is the most happiest guy. I said, go ahead and do it. After 30 days, he calls me and tells me, Murali, I think I will take back my words. Whatever you said is right. I am 50% more happier now, more than ever. Thank you very much for giving me this technique. I would like to follow this technique for the rest of my life. How many of you in this room would like to know this one technique which can give you 50% more happiness? Would you be interested? Type the word I or me in the chat box so that I know that you are also interested to practice this one technique which can actually give you 50% more happiness now more than ever. But I'm not going to tell you now. Just hold on. I'm not going to tell you now. After some time, I will tell you. Let me see if you can remember it. Okay. If anyone can remember it, just type the word lift in the chat box later, not now. So then let me see if you guys can still remember the first story of mine. Because always everyone wants to be happier. Everyone, whomever you meet, any your client, your vendor, your BNI members, your family members, your neighbors, everyone wants to be happy. Yes or no? No one says that I want to be unhappy. Did you wake up today with a thought that today should be the unhappy day for you? Today should be the worst day for you? I'm sure no one wakes up like that. If they wake up like that, then you have to send them to the asylum. Yes or no? So everyone wants to be happier. And whatever they do, they just want happiness in their life. But more than happiness, people ask me how to teach happiness, how to learn happiness. I will always tell you, more than the keys of happiness, there are two keys for unhappiness in our life. If you can understand these two keys of unhappiness in our life, we can always become happier and successful, because happy people are the most successful people in the world. So I'm going to share with you these two keys of unhappiness today. And if you can understand this and remove these two keys from your life, you will always be happier and successful. Can I share that with you? Are you guys ready to learn what are these two keys of unhappiness? Go ahead and say yes in the chat box. Let me see how many of you are paying attention, because 104 people are there in the room. Okay, good. Many of you are already interested. Thank you. There are various reasons why unhappiness and sufferings are caused. Right now, one is COVID. Okay. Right now, the lockdown may cause some tension in your life. Before I share with you these two keys, let me be very honest and upfront with you. Will the world be the same after the lockdown? No. 100% I can guarantee you, the world is never going to be the same. The world will never go back to normal. It will go back to a new normal. Here is a question. Are you ready to face the new normal? Are you ready to change yourself? Are you ready to change your business to face the new normal? That's a question that you should be asking right now. Because right now, these two keys of unhappiness is continuously playing in your head. That's the reason we are not ready to face that, because it's a little scary world. No? Let me be very honest with you. It's going to be a little scary for many, many industries. I saw some of the questions. Hey, be ready to change your category or look out for another opportunity. In another few years from now, there may be a lot of changes in the whole way in which the whole world itself is going to do business. Because these are all lot of scary things that's going to happen. And why? Because of all these things, continuously these two keys are continuously triggered into us, which causes us more suffering and more unhappiness. The number one key for unhappiness in the world is called donkey. You know, do you know the spelling of donkey? D-O-N-K-E-Y. The number one reason why is because of the donkey. Have you seen a donkey, guys? Have you seen a donkey? Do you know what does a donkey do? What's a job of a donkey? Anyone knows what's the job of a donkey? The job of a donkey is to carry a lot of weight. Okay, it carries loads. That's the purpose and job of the donkey. Yes or no? Like how a donkey carries a lot of weight, if you observe your own life, you will find one interesting donkey within all of us. I'll give you an example. There are situations when, you know, remember when we were meeting offline, okay, BNI chapter meetings. You enter into the hotel, you get into the lobby, probably there is a lift, you enter into the lobby and enter into the lift, and you are about to go on sign the registration sheet, that time a member will come and say, good morning. And this is the person with whom you really won't want to see also, but he's the first person you will meet and say, good morning. You will really want to, really, you will keep cribbing, and then why the hell I met him in the morning? Yeah, shit, you'll be thinking like that. There are certain people in our life, we don't want to meet them in the morning. They will be the first person to wish us good morning. Sometimes we get irritated. There are some people who will cause enough irritation and frustration. We really want to go and give a tight slap also. Yes or no? But we can't do that. In our own company also, there are a lot of unique characters we have. They cause us enough irritation in our life. And there are some people, some of our own clients, I don't know how many of you have. Once upon a time, I had lots and lots of nagging and irritating and frustrating clients. They will be the first guy to call in the morning and they start screaming and shouting at you and irritate you to the core. Have you experienced some clients like that? You really want to shout at them and say, get lost, but you can't do that. Sometimes in your own home itself, you want to shout and scream. Or there are situations where you really feel very upset. You really want to cry also, but you will not do that. Why? Because of family rules, society rules, office rules, BNI rules, all bullshit rules, everything you have created in your life. Because of all these things, I'm sure each one of you watching this program will agree with me. There are many, many, many situations in our life. Instead of expressing our true emotion, we suppress the original feeling and we put a smile. Probably when your support director or executive director will be asking you to do something, you know it is not possible to bring that visitor, but you will smile at him. Yes, yes, sir, I will bring, sir, visitors. How many of you have done that? You know that you are not going to bring. Your ED or director also knows that you are not going to bring also. But still, we all say, yes, yes. How many of you have experienced something like this that you have not released the original emotion? Let me see how many honest people are there in the room right now. Have you all experienced something like this right from your childhood to till now? That you really want to express the original feeling, but instead of expressing the original feeling, you put a different emotions in your face. Thank you for many people saying honestly many times also. Yes, absolutely. Every day we go through this with our spouse, with our kids, with our clients, with our family members. There are many, many situations that come in our life. We do that. So what is happening? Instead of expressing the original emotion, which started from our body and mind, we suppress that and we put a different feeling. So right from our childhood to till now, there are a lot of situations where we have suppressed these emotions and we are carrying these emotions as emotional burden within us. And like the donkey, we have learned to carry these emotional loads with us. You would have experienced for no reason, suddenly, due to unforeseen, something would have happened and you would have bursted with anger with your child, with your family member or with your staff. For no reason, just like that, it would have erupted like a volcano. Today, medical science says, almost every disease that we are going through in our life is because of these stress, emotional burden related stress that we are carrying within us. The number one reason for all the health related disorder, even the immunity low, is also because of these emotional burdens that we are carrying. All we need to know is how you can kick the donkey out of your life. If you know how to kick this donkey, this burden inside you, you will always be happier. How many of you would like to learn how to kick this donkey out of your life and always stay peaceful and calm? Let me see how many of you are interested to learn. Just type the word me in the chat box. Would you be interested to know how to kick this donkey, be more calm, be more relaxed, come what may, whatever happens? Thank you for that awesome participation in the chat box and saying me. Thank you guys. Thank you very much for that. Thank you. So the number one key, what is the number one key? Do you remember the number one key? I told you two keys are there. Number one key is called the donkey. Fantastic. The number one key is donkey. And the number two key is the most difficult key. And that key is called the monkey. How many of you have seen monkey in your life? How many of you seen monkey in your life? Hey, not in the mirror, not in the mirror. In real life, have you seen a mirror? Have you seen a monkey in your life? Not in the mirror. Wait, have you seen a monkey? Monkey, you know, what does a monkey do? What does a monkey do? Monkey doesn't sit in one place. It keeps on jumping from one place to another place. Yes or no? It doesn't sit in one place. Like a monkey doesn't sit in one place, there is one more person within us. There is one more thing within us which keeps on jumping from one place to another place. And that's called our mind. You know, have you experienced your mind? And maybe today you just recall your own day from morning to till now. Half the time would have mind would have gone to the past. All the past situations would have replayed in your head. And you will be thinking, oh, what and all difficulties I have gone through. You don't know how much difficulties I have gone through in life. And your monkey mind will be playing that. And if the past gets bored, the monkey goes to the future and starts thinking when the COVID will get over. Once the COVID will get over, all my problems will be solved. Probably I will start doing more business. So you will go to the future. If both the things are not interesting, your monkey mind will go to the fantasy channel which you have created inside you. In the fantasy world, you are the Batman, you are the Spider-Man, you are the Avengers, you are the Iron Man. You will solve every problem in your fantasy world. Yes or no? How many of you keep experiencing all these different worlds inside you? The past, the future, or to the fantasy? Non-stop. Even right now, for the last 40 minutes, this conference have started. How many times you have observed your monkey mind jumping here and there? It is not focused always here. That's the interesting part of the monkey. And we have never learned how to keep the monkey in this moment of life. If you learn how to keep this monkey mind in this moment of life, you will always become happier. But it's very difficult. Why? For some of you, the monkey is not an ordinary monkey. It is a wild monkey. Not only just a wild monkey, probably a drunken monkey also inside you. I don't know what kind of monkey you are feeding inside. You know, generally it starts in the morning. You know, when you start waking up in the morning, if you have a habit of brushing your teeth, ask yourself or recall any day where you are brushing. What were you doing when you were brushing? The hand will be brushing your teeth and mind would have gone somewhere else. What to do today? What are the various phone calls to do? Whom and all should I send proposal? What should I cook? What time should I leave? The hand is only brushing. Mind has gone out for an excursion. Yes or no? Or whenever you are taking bath, instead of enjoying how the water is falling on your body, we allow our mind to go everywhere. So this is how we train our mind in all these mundane activity. Very small, micro mundane activity. We allow the mind to go everywhere outside. We have never put in efforts to put the mind in this current moment of living. Successful business leaders, happy people, they all understand that if I have to become happier and productive and achieve more success, I need to learn how to handle this donkey and also how to handle this monkey. Handling the donkey is sometimes easier, but handling the monkey is the most difficult task. Probably you can do a lot of practices and kick the donkey away, but the monkey will never go out of you. It will always be there within you. And your job is whenever the monkey goes out, bring it back within you. If it goes out, bring it back within you. I'm going to share with you some simple techniques now, simple practices now, which can help you to handle this monkey and donkey. How many of you will learn this today and take action? Will you be ready to take action? Type the word action in the chat box. Let me see how many of you are ready to take action after learning. Are you sure? Will you take action? Wow, many of them are saying that yes, you will take action. Can I tell you a secret? I'm going to tell you a secret. 97% of the people who say that I will take action have never taken it. You know why? It's because of the lift technique. Someone mentioned to me lift technique. 97% of the people in the world will never take action. I'm sure that you already know that walking is good for health. Are you going for walking? No. You already know eating junk food is bad for health. Are you stopping that? No. You already know what to do, but you are not doing. There is only one difference between successful and unsuccessful people. Successful people take action. Unsuccessful people, they keep on wondering what to do next. You know, that's because of the lift, you know. You really want to handle this monkey and donkey. I know that you are very curious to handle this monkey and donkey because it's your daily problem. It is not a one-day problem. It is an everyday problem of you. Every day we are burdened with a lot of emotional burdens. Right now, many of you will be going through it because a lot of payment is not coming. A lot of uncertainty is there right now. You don't know what is the future right now. We don't know how the whole thing will open up. So it's going to be a little panicking situation right now. We don't know. So always the monkey and donkey is always triggered. Why? The number one reason why we don't take action is because of the top three industries in the world, which always wants you in that particular situation. The top three industries of the world are weapons industry, healthcare industry, and alcohol industry. And look at all the three industries. The first industry will kill you. The third industry will make you sick. And the second industry tries to revive you and see what's happening right now in the world. No. All the three industries, if they have to be always in the top three, they need one element in every human being which continuously triggers this donkey and monkey, and that is called fear. Any human being who doesn't have a fear, that means a fearless mind, is always the happiest mind and a successful mind. But this fear is continuously installed into all of us through an amazing system called media, ensuring that all of us watch television and read newspaper. It is made mandatory into everybody's life. And that's how this fear is continuously installed. And in the lift, I told my friend, if you really want to be happier in your life, stop watching television and stop reading newspaper. That's all I told him. He literally got angry with me. How the hell I can stop doing that? Without watching TV, how will I live my life? Without reading newspaper, how can I know current affairs? No, it can't be possible. But ladies and gentlemen, ask yourself this question. In any newspaper you have read so far, anything positive has come? No. In any of the TV that you're watching, anything is positive? No. Then how the hell you can be positive and successful when the whole world is throwing negative at you? It's not possible, right? Here is a question to you. Here is a challenge to you. How many of you are ready for a 30-day challenge of no TV, no newspaper? Are you ready? Are you ready for a challenge? 30 days. No TV, no newspaper. And people have asked me, Murali, are you crazy? How will I know all the latest current affairs if I don't watch TV and newspaper? This is what I keep telling everyone. If the information is really, 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 really important, okay? One joker will always send me that message in WhatsApp, or he will put as a status update on Facebook. Enough, no, I will get the whole information, yes or no. Why should I read the whole newspaper, digest all the information, and segregate the positive and negative news and keep myself sane inside? It's not possible. We believe that our willpower will help us, but literally we are not possible. Look at the way in which the whole thing is working. It is not possible at all to handle the negativity coming up from the newspaper or with the TV television network right now. That's what I told my friend, that stop reading newspaper or stop watching television. Some of you may be able to do that. Some of you may not be able to do that. And Sai Ramakrishnan saying, sir, what are you telling? I'm into the business of paper advertisements. How can I handle that? Hey, in paper, what is the best thing? If you ask me what is the best thing in the newspaper, is always an advertisement. Because advertisement is always keeps you happy because they are selling you something. They are solving a problem. That's the only thing that is very good in any advertisement, in any newspaper at all. Or the only thing in television is always advertisement, which always keeps you happier at least for 15 seconds. Because 15 seconds, Kellogg's advertisement teaches you how you can become slim. 15 seconds of Fair and Lovely teaches you how you can become fair. In 15 seconds, they give you the confidence, you know. That's the reason why, you need to learn. That's the reason BNI, we also teach you how you can quickly talk about your business in a faster way by talking about the benefits of the product instead of cribbing about the problem. So reason why I'm just telling you all these things is that you are really wanted to take action. The only challenge that you are not able to take action is because of the fear that comes inside us. And right now what's happening? Every day you wake up and you check the WhatsApp, check the TV, check the newspaper, full of COVID. You don't know when is the lockdown is going to go normal. And every day, varieties of perception people are giving you. And you continuously digest all the information and keep on thinking, what will happen to my business? Yes or no? Is it happening right now in your life? Just say yes or no if it's happening in your life right now. And now tell me how it's possible for us to be happy. That is where we need to learn how we can handle this happiness. I was doing a research a few years before I was involved in a neuroscience research to understand why human beings don't take action. For me, I was always more curious that all human beings know what to do, but why they are not ready to do. So I was always curious to know what is that root cause of inaction of human beings. So since I'm a student of neuroscience, I've studied neuroscience, I'm also a student of yogic science from the age of 8. I'm practicing yoga and meditation. So I wanted to understand how exactly both are interlinked. And I studied a subject, and in that they were telling me that in the year 1909, a scientist by name Dr. Broadman mapped the whole brain, and he said that there are different areas in the brain responsible for only one action. Specific area in the brain responsible for one action. So I was more curious to know if there is only one area in the brain responsible for one action, then also to take action, there is one area in the brain. So I was more curious to know where is that area in the brain which is responsible for us to take action so that we can become successful. So when I went deeper into that, I found out there is an amazing connection between how human beings breathe, how it impacts the heartbeat, and how it impacts the brain's performance itself. Thereby, we can become successful and happier. What I found out is on an average, an Indian citizen is breathing somewhere between 14 to 20 times per minute and a heartbeat of 85 in a normal, no stress situation. Because of this rapid breathing and heavy load on the heart, the brain is not working at the fullest performance. Then I realized that there is one specific area in the brain which is responsible for action taking also. And when I studied more than 25,000 people, they are all billionaires, millionaires, CEO, business owners, professionals. I did this testing. There's a separate technology using a software and a hardware. You can actually measure everybody's thoughts. You can measure every thought people have. You can measure how many times they breathe, how the heart is getting affected, and how the brain gets affected, and how much stress is created. So when I did this, I found an amazing similarity of happy and successful people in the world. People who are really successful and they are happy and healthy, they were not breathing 14 to 20 times a minute. They were all breathing only 7 or 8 breaths only per minute. Yes, the reason for their success and happiness is they were all breathing very slowly. Only 7 or 8 breaths per minute. And their heart is beating only at 70 beats per minute. And the brain was working very effectively. And oxygen was flowing enough to the action center of the brain. And this is the area called the prefrontal cortex, which is the action center of the brain. When this area of the brain receives enough oxygen supply, you will take action. You will not keep thinking. If this area of the brain receives oxygen, you will not be scared. You will not be unhappy, because this is also the happiness center of the brain also. So I was more curious to know how this whole thing works. And when I studied yogic science, our ancestors 2000 years before said that if you really want to be happier and healthier and achieve peak performance in 1 minute, all you need is only 5 breaths per minute. That's their prescription of success. 5 breaths per minute is the prescription for happiness and longevity and amazing success. This brain will work at the peak performance potential. I'm talking about one breath, inhale and exhale is 1 breath, 5 times a minute. That's enough. That's all you need to do, breathe in and breathe out. If you can do that, you will automatically become more happier and successful. But people don't accept, old elders' advice. They always want what is the current science says, okay? Even neuroscience went and studied and says that this human body gets autonomic balance only at 5 breaths per minute, and the brain is always at the peak performance at 5 breaths a minute. So why am I saying this here to you as a science? Because the easier way to handle, the monkey inside you is by paying full attention to the air going in and coming out. People, when they breathe slowly and deeply, you have two side effects. Number one, you automatically become very powerful with your brain's processor speed. Number two, the side effect is when you focus on your breathing, you also handle your monkey inside you. That means your monkey cannot go outside. Maybe you can try this experiment. Whenever you put your attention on your breathing, that means you breathe in slowly and deeply, you will always find the monkey will not go out. You will always come back to this current moment. Just go ahead and try it right now. As you are sitting, just sit straight. Just adjust your body. Put your whole attention to the tip of the nose. Slowly and gently close your eyes. And take one nice deep breath in and feel the chill air going inside your nose. And slowly and gently breathe out and feel the warm air coming out of your nose. Let's try one more time. I'm seeing that you guys are not doing it. Some of you, just go ahead and do one more time. Breathe in slowly and feel the chill air at the tip of your nose. Go slowly inside. Breathe in slowly inside and breathe out slowly outside and feel the warm air coming out. How many of you did it? Just say me in the chat box. Let me see How many of you really took action right now, as I was telling you? When you focus on your breath, the side effect is you are actually bringing the whole monkey in this moment of now. So whenever your monkey mind goes out, all you need is the very simple practice in the world by just focusing your attention onto your breath. When you bring your attention to your breathing, you will always find the monkey mind calms down. You suddenly become more calm. You suddenly become more poised. Only when your mind is calm, please remember, only when your mind is calm, you can access your emotional intelligence, because only when your mind is calm, you are emotionally balanced. Only when you are emotionally balanced, only you can use your intelligence. Otherwise, you would have seen many, many intelligent people making emotional mistakes. That's the reason yoga psychology always says all you need is 5 breaths per minute and 60 heartbeats in 1 minute. If you can sink 60 seconds to 60 heartbeat and breathe only 5 times a minute, you are handling the monkey to be here and the now, and the brain processor speed happens like the latest i10 processor of Apple. That's the speed in which your brain starts understanding patterns. You will quickly come up with solutions for any challenges in your life. So all you need to handle the monkey is breathe slowly and deeply. How many of you understood what I just said? Say me in the chat box. Let me see how many of you actually followed me and understood. And when you analyze your own breath, it will always slow. Whenever you analyze your breath, that means you pay attention, you will always breathe slowly. Okay. So, you know, without putting awareness, is it possible to test? No. There are various now parameters. A lot of Fitbit are there, which tells you the heart rate variability and your heartbeat. See whether you can test your heartbeat even under stressful condition. See, it doesn't exceed beyond 70. If you can keep your heartbeat within 60 to 70, you can stay focused. Your mind will not go here and there. Because heart is the switchboard for the monkey. If the heart beats faster, monkey mind will travel faster. If the heart beats slowly, the monkey mind sits here in the now. So this is one practice as of now, which is very easy to practice. As of now, this breathing is free. There is no GST. There is no VAT for this. All you need is sit in one place. Every day before you go to sleep, practice for 40 breaths. 40 breaths. That means 8 breaths per minute for 5 minutes. That means 40 breaths. Pay attention for 40 breaths. And similarly, when you wake up in the morning, just give some 40 breaths for you. I think you deserve that 40 breaths. Yes or no? Because that 40 breaths in the morning, that means your full 100% attention given 40 breaths in the morning and 40 breaths in the night will take care of the whole body for the whole day. You will never feel tired. You will never feel upset. You will always run with lots and lots of energy. So how many of you are here ready right now, understood this practice and ready to take action? Morning 40 breaths and evening 40 breaths. That means 5 minutes in the morning for your own breathing and 5 minutes in the night for your own breathing. That is, even today it should start once this webinar is over. Hey, remember one thing, whether you like it or not, you are breathing. Yes or no, whether you like it or not, you are all breathing. I am just asking you to put little bit of attention to that breathing going in and coming out. That's it. I am just asking you to do only breathing through both the nostril. Just sit in one place, take a nice deep breath in and breathe out. That's all. I am not talking about even the higher level practice of breathing through the one nostril and releasing through the another nostril. These are all very high-end techniques. I am talking about the basic breathing practice. Many of us, 97% of the humanity, don't practice this basic stuff. So if you really want to become successful, if you really want to be happier, always, now more than ever, one simple practice is breathe in slowly and breathe out slowly. This is one simple practice which will help you to handle the monkey in this moment of now. Thereby, we can always stay stable inside. No COVID can disturb us. No business situation can disturb us. We can always be steady inside us. Remember one thing. All the great leaders, okay? Number one thing that they always put attention to is the relaxation of the mind. Come what may. Because the world is going to continuously change. Here now one situation has come. Next year something else is going to come. After that something else is going to come. So always this fluctuation is always going to be there. But whatever happens, can we just stay calm inside? Can you be calm inside the chaos? That's what this technique will always bring in. Thereby, the monkey is always under your control. Whenever you practice this, right now your monkey mind goes out. Probably after 5 minutes only, you realize, oh my God, I got distracted. Let me come back and do it. The more and more you practice, what happens? Maybe 5 minutes later, instead of becoming aware, maybe within 2 minutes, you will become aware that you got distracted. The more you practice, you will find out that in 30 seconds itself. The more you start practicing, what will happen? The minute the monkey goes out of you, you will instantly catch the monkey and bring it back inside you. That means you will not lose your attention always. You can always stay attentive in this moment of now. That's the biggest gift that we all can give ourselves in these lockdown period. Because anyhow, this is lockdown time. We have nothing to do. Just go ahead and make this breathing as your one practice to handle the monkey. Okay. So this is one technique for the monkey. Let me quickly tell you the one technique for the donkey now, before we go and close the session for your question answers. Okay. What is one technique for donkey? See, donkey comes because of emotional burden, and many, many successful leaders, what they do is they do a very simple practice before every single day. You know, every day we go through a roller coaster of emotions. Sometimes you are happy, sometimes you are sad, sometimes you are irritated, sometimes you are frustrated. You know, it goes through a roller coaster of emotion. Throughout the whole day, we are not happy at all. Okay, we go through that. So what generally many successful leaders, happy people do is, before they complete the day, before they rest the day, okay, they take a pen and a notebook and they write in that notebook what one happy moment happened today. They write today's date and then just write down. They just scan the whole day and pick and choose one happiest memory and then write it down. And they also below that they write, wow, what is the one thing I'm very thankful for today? They just write a gratitude note below that. You know, just imagine this is going to take only 5 minutes maximum to pick up any one happy memory of today. I'm sure that throughout the whole day, you will always pick up any one happy moment. At least someone smiled at you. They brought some happiness. Someone opened their door for you and helped you. Probably that could have also give you happiness. So every day, just imagine you pick up a diary and a notebook and start writing this gratitude journal, or I call these as happiness journal. Imagine that you are able to do that for 3 to 4 days every single week, probably 150 days in a year. Whenever you get frustrated, irritated, you know, emotionally down, go to this diary and randomly open this diary. What you will see is your own happy memory. You will start reading. And when you read your own happy memory, the brain is a very funny organ. When it reads a happy memory, it recollects the same scene inside the head. And according to the brain, it is happening right now. And since it is recalling a happy memory, brain releases happy chemicals in your body, happy hormones like endorphins, endocannabinoids, enkephalins. All these things are instantly released in the whole body, and instantly your mood gets elevated. So your own happiness journal becomes a mood elevator and instantly removes the donkey from your life. So this one gratitude journal or happiness journal is one simple method to handle the donkey every single day. Remember, when you leave the work at the work spot. When you leave the home at the work spot. If you can practice this, this itself will help you not to mix both the destination, home and the office. And number three, if you really want to handle the donkey, I'm telling you, very simple. Whenever you're angry, show the anger at someone. You want to shout at someone, shout at them. You want to cry, cry. Don't care about whether what others will think of you. This one problem only is causing the donkey to get activated. No, what others will think of me. Get rid of that. Okay, others will think of you something today. Tomorrow they will think something differently. And day after tomorrow they will think something else. So you cannot live for somebody's thinking. Okay, so don't claim your intellectual property rights for somebody's thoughts or opinions. You just live your life. If you want to feel like crying, just cry it out. You want to shout, shout it out. It's their problem, how they perceive it, you. Okay, so this is a very simple process of handling the donkey, of writing a gratitude journal, or if you want to practice emotions, whatever emotion that comes out of you, just release it. It's their problem now to handle it. It's not your problem because you have released it. Okay. Whichever you think it's possible, you can practice. There are various other practices are there in yoga and meditation, which I teach in my happiness workshop. There are varieties of practices which you can actually do using breathing to kill the donkey also permanently. But just right now in the webinar format, I can't teach you that. So that's the reason I'm sharing with you some simple practices that you all can follow in your day-to-day life. I hope you all understood what I just said right now. One is just focus on your deep abdominal breathing, 40 breaths in the morning and 40 breaths in the night to handle the monkey, and then writing the gratitude journal in the night to handle the donkey. How many of you are ready to take any one of these actions? What one action will you take? Just go ahead and type in the chat box. Which one technique are you ready to follow after listening to this particular session? Okay, how you can be happier at any time? Both. Okay, both. Someone says both. Someone says breathing. Okay. Thank you. Some of you says both. Happiness journal, breathing, both. Okay, Sony Vargi says breathing. Thank you, Karthagain, for breathing. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Both me breathing, ready for breathing. Okay, Rajesh, thank you. Breathing and journal says Bhaskaran. Mohammed says, Salim says breathing. Doing the journal. We'll start the breathing. Thank you. Anand Padmanabhan says breathing. Breathing already. I will start with journal. Rajiv Bagri, thank you. Breathing technique and live your life. Absolutely, Anto. You just have to live your life on your own terms. Now, this is my favorite business way, my way of living, doing business. Huh? Many people ask me, how the hell are you always happier and you know how you do business? I have a very simple formula for business. Huh? Get profitable in doing what I love to do with the type of clients with whom I want to work with in the way I want to do my business. Okay. Very simple business mantra I have. Get profitable. That means business means you need to be profitable. Get profitable in doing what I love to do with the type of people with whom I want to do. I don't want to do business with everyone. I'm very clear with whom I want to do business with. And I'm very clear in the way I want to do my business. So if you can align all these things properly, get profitable, doing what you love with the type of clients you want to work with in the way you want to do, if you can align these four, no COVID will come and destroy your business. You will always do your business in the right way. And now more than ever, ladies and gentlemen, this is the time where we need to do a lot of contemplation and deep thinking of what are the various things that I can bring change in my business to face the new normal world. The new normal world will always throw us a lot of challenges. But remember, with every challenge, there is an equal and higher opportunity for us to grow. If you are going to do business in the same way that you are doing till yesterday, you are inviting trouble in your life. You are actually going to stimulate your donkey and the monkey. But understand, the new normal is going to be different, and all we need is prepare ourselves to face the new normal world. That's the reason I shared with you these two techniques, which will help you to prepare to face the new world. And all the answers for all your challenges and questions are already inside you. You already know what to do in your life. You are just hesitating to take that action. When you do this practice, your mind becomes very calm. The mind becomes very clear. You will now be able to take clear action, and that will give you, propel the direction of your business itself. I hope you really enjoyed this particular talk of mine for the last 45 minutes. I hope this was really, really useful for you to go back and apply in your business life and also in your personal life. If you guys have any questions with respect to any of these things, go ahead and post your question, and then I can answer any of your questions which is relevant to this topic or anything related to business. If you guys want to ask, go ahead and ask. I will be very happy, because by 10 o'clock I can close this whole session. Thank you. Any question, guys, just go ahead and post it in the Q&A box. And if you guys are interested to learn happiness techniques on a daily basis, I teach happiness for free through my daily email happiness course. If you guys are interested, you can go and visit happinesscourse.com. You can register your name and email ID, and every day I will send you one happiness lesson. And if you guys are really interested to learn more, visit unlimitedhappiness.com, where I can actually share with you how you can always be more happier. Is meditation the same as conscious breathing? Arnav Agarwal, thank you very much. Breathing is the first step, okay? And as you start focusing on breathing, meditation happens, because you cannot do meditation in life, Arnav. No one in the world can do meditation. It can only happen. And when you start focusing on your breathing, and the more and more and more you start concentrating on the breath, what will happen is you get inside the stage called dhyana. Okay, that's called meditation. So we can't do it. It has to happen. Okay, so thank you very much, guys. Any other questions, just go ahead and post. And if any one of you want to know more about happiness, you can visit my website called unlimitedhappiness.com. I'll be very happy to help you. And first question, or I went off in between because signals. Have you missed the first question? Or yeah, I don't know, Rajiv, what question you asked.
Ramachandra TM.
Yapshad, go ahead.
Yeah, we have a question from Ramachandra TM. He's asking, happiness neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be transferred from one person to another person. Can you elaborate on it?
Oh, absolutely true, Ramachandran, because happiness can either be created or destroyed, because you're already the epitome of happiness. You are the foundation of happiness. You are born happy only. And when you are happy, this is the best thing. When you are happy, okay, this is the best gift you can give to your family members. Because when you're happy, the whole family becomes happier. So obviously that happiness can be transferred to another person. And when you're happy, the family becomes happy. When the family is happy, the society is happy, and the nation is happy. So the best gift you can give to the whole world is you being happy, come what may, whatever happens. And you don't have to do anything to become happy. Remove all the negativities inside you. Remove all the unnecessary rules that you have created. Remove all the negative beliefs and expectations that you have kept with others on situation. When you remove all the expectations, you will spot happiness inside you always. People ask me, how are you always happier? I have a very simple process. Less is more is my formula. Breathe less, you will get more happiness. Less expectation. I actually have no expectation at all with anyone or with any situation. I just go with no expectation in any situation or any people in life. So obviously there is no weight inside my head at all. So obviously I'm always happier, and that's the reason people who see me also, they also get the happiness, and that's how you can actually transfer happiness a lot. I hope that answered your question.
Okay, we have another question from Vinod. He's asking, can I watch television other than news channel?
Oh, hey, first 30 days, don't watch anything. What will happen is when you have learned the practice of not watching television for 1 month, you will get the vairagya and willpower to pick and choose whether this is the right information or not. After that, you will know how to, you know, like, you know, a swan can segregate the milk and the water. You will be able to segregate it.
Okay. Bestin Joy is asking, do you teach this in a separate course? I would love to learn this in depth.
Okay. Yes, Bestin. I run a one full day happiness workshop where I teach 22 varieties of techniques of how you can always be happier, healthier, and successful. So we can always organize one separate, one full day workshop on this once the lockdown is removed.
Okay, Anish is asking, I used to wake up at 5 o'clock and read the book and start my routine, but I feel sleepy in the morning day. What is the best time to wake up and sleep?
Thank you, Anish, for that question. See, every human body has a particular circadian rhythm. Some of them are early birds, some of them are night owls. And you need to figure out your own rhythm of the body. Everybody will tell you what is the exact time that you can wake up. Thereby, your energy levels are always going up instead of going down. If you wake up at 5 o'clock and your energy levels are going down, then you are waking a little early. Just move it to 5:30 or 6 o'clock. You will always find yourself happier. And also check what time you're sleeping in the night. That also matters a lot. And if you know how to align your body rhythm to your sleeping pattern, you will get the right, the right concoction of which is the right time for you to wake up. And if you think that waking up and reading a book also making you sleepy, probably you can start doing some exercises, some breathing and, goal setting, and then you can get into reading. Thereby, you're energized the whole body, and then you can start reading also. So you have to do your own trial and error. There is no one common methodology. I wake up at 4 a.m. It works for me. Will it work for everyone? No. So you need to figure your own method for your own body. Yes, Abhishek, any other question?
Narendra Sharma is saying, when I lose in business, I go in depression. How will I be happy with peaceful mind if breathing technique is not working?
Thank you, Narendra Sharma. The reason why you are getting into depression is because you have too much expectation from your own business, and probably some of the strategies are not working. And because of that, you're repeating the same thing again and again and again with the hope that some miracle will happen. Some of the best times in business is stop doing it. When you stop doing it itself, you will avoid a lot of losses in your business, which will give you happiness. And I know one of my friends, she always tells me that she wants to be in the Forbes magazine. She wants to be the world's top 10 rich person in the world when she's actually not able to make even month end needs itself. So sometimes if the business doesn't work, you need to know how to change the whole business process itself and find the exact problem in business which is causing you the depression. Because if you are not going to analyze the root cause of your business, no breathing technique is going to give you happiness. So better you address the root cause which is causing you unhappiness in your life, in your business life, probably wrong strategy, probably wrong team, probably the wrong product to the wrong target customer. There are 101 reasons are there. If you can identify that, sit with a business coach, sit with a mentor or life coach. They can look at it from a third person's point of view and give you a suggestion. And when you take action, automatically you will come out of that. And whether you see, business will always go up and down. Just because business is not working, you can't focus on breathing. Because anyhow you have to breathe, right? If you have to stay alive, anyhow you have to breathe. So treat the business as a separate entity. Don't get attached too much with business. The reason many of us get upset is because we get too much attached with the business. You have to run a business as if it is for someone else. Any day you are ready to sell this business, always you need to run a business that way. Then always you will be detached. See, I am only working in this business. This business probably belongs to God, or probably this business belongs to my wife. I'm only an employer in that. If you can detach yourself and work in a business, that's the best way. You will never get unhappiness in your business. I hope that answered various answers to Narendra Sharma over there.
Okay, Jitin PR is asking, any particular color that gives you happiness as per your experience?
Hey, there is no specific color for happiness and all. Again, for every human being, different colors are there. And it is all based on a little bit of chakra activation in the body. For some people, certain chakras are very active, so they like that particular color. So literally, there are different colors are there. There is no one color. I like blue color a lot. For me, I like white color a lot. So for some of them, they may like orange. Some of them like red. Some of them may like yellow. It's a separate topic itself. Color psychology itself is a separate subject to discuss. And it's a very deep subject. Depending upon what color you choose, there are a lot of behaviors can be analyzed also. So there's no one color. Huh? Every color is different. And as you age, as the experience changes, as your belief system changes, colors also change along with you.
Okay, we have a testimonial from Satish actually. I am very happy after unlimited happiness workshop. Now people calls and dump their crisis fear on me. I started to think of it for a while and nullify it. So thank you.
You have become a counselor then.
Thank you, Satish, for sharing your experience with us. And next we have a question from Priya Chandran. How do we find out what is it that we love to do, and does it necessarily have to be just one thing?
Priya, how do you find what is that one thing you love to do? Okay, the best answer lies in your teenage life. Okay, go to your parents and ask your parents at the age of 12 and 13, what is that one activity I was doing from morning to evening again and again and again and again? Yeah, you're continuously cribbing and telling me don't do it. Or ask yourself, what is that one thing that I can do from morning to night, non-stop, even if no one is paying me even 1 rupee? Even if someone is not ready to pay me any money, I am ready to do that one action because it gives me the ultimate happiness and satisfaction. Figure out that one action that you love to do, even if no one is ready to pay for you, that becomes your love of your life. And it will always keep changing, Priya. This year it is gardening. Next year, probably it is singing. The following year, it may be something else also. So it is not one thing. You can always find happiness in multiple things also. If you think that art and craft and painting and music and singing and business, everything you love to do, go ahead and explore everything. And this is where as parents, we also have to teach our children to give them the enough opportunity to explore them so that they will figure out what is their ikigai. What is the ikigai for them? So go ahead and try everything and explore. Only with exploration you're going to find this out, Priya. There is no methodology, there is no formula, nothing else is there. The whole purpose of life is to figure out what is the purpose of life and what is that one thing I love to do, thereby my purpose of life is fulfilled. So go ahead and experiment it. There is no right or wrong answer, Priya.
Okay, we have another question from Anish Sugmaran. How we can improve the episodic memory when we drive? Some of them often forget the location while we drive. They cannot identify the place where they visited earlier. For instance, if I have go to Coimbatore, which I have already visited the place, second time I forgot the way to that location. How we can recollect the places?
Anish, the number one reason why memory loss happens, that short-term memory loss happens, is because of lack of oxygen to the prefrontal cortex of the brain. That is this forehead area. Okay, so that's the reason why the short-term memory loss happens or unable to remember. Okay, this area is responsible for short-term memory also. So if you start practicing the deep abdominal slow and deep breathing every single day, you will find this area getting activated and you will always remember that. Okay, whichever location you want to go. And take the help of someone next to you who can remind you or keep some alarms in your phone or any which way until you get that perfectly done. Okay. And also, it also talks about you are becoming a little older. The cells are becoming older. The cells are dying inside you. That is also one reason. And then look into your whole diet habit. What kind of food are you eating? Are you eating the right combination of protein and vitamins? Thereby, the body is kept healthy. The memory cells are really, really activated. And there are various other, sound vibrations are also available. If you go and talk to a sound healer, they will give you certain sounds which can activate the memory cells in your body. Certain kinds of food can activate the memory cells in your body. Breathing can activate the memory in your body. So it's a multiple combination you need to try, Anish. Only when you try it, you will know it. Otherwise, there is no one method I can say that, okay, go do this, you will get it. If I'm telling you this, then I'm cheating you. And that's how many people rob your money also. Okay, be very careful. If someone says this is the only way, it means they are robbing your money.
Okay, Rajiv was saying, I don't have a fixed time for sleep and wake, but I sleep 8 hours. Is it okay?
One of the best habit or quality of many successful leaders is, come what may, let the heaven may fall, they go to sleep in the same time and wake up in the same time. By doing that, the body is always kept healthy because it is a hormonal cycle. A lot of chemical changes are happening in the body and you need to exactly pick up that cue and the signal that the body tells you that, yes, you need to go and sleep now. So every single day, you need to go to bed at the same time and wake up at the same time. That one rhythm, if you can set in the body very correctly, you will find your body is always healthy, you're always happier, and most of the life problems are solved. Though 8 hours sleep is very good, it is always required, but you know, if you keep on changing the waking and sleeping time, you are confusing the body cells here. So one fine day, till you are healthy, it's okay, but one fine day, something comes and hits your body's health, and after that, the whole thing starts shattering. So if you don't want that to happen, if you really want to keep yourself healthy always till the last day of your life, right now you can start amalgamating or start aligning your sleep pattern, because sleep is one thing many business owners don't put attention to, and that is the reason why many business owners die of heart attack. Many medical research has gone there and said that the reason why many business owners die because of the tension is because of their irregular sleep pattern. So if I am you, I will immediately put this immediately into action of sleeping at the right time and waking up at the right time. Hope that answers your question, Rajiv.
Okay. Piyush is asking, I would like to know how I can be happy in such a way that it is transferred to my employees, customers and suppliers. How should I treat them and be with them to achieve this?
You know, it's a very simple way Krishna said that in Bhagavad Gita, do your action, don't expect any results. Just do your karma, do your action only in your life. When you just do your action, the results will automatically follow, but don't have expectations on the result. Okay, in your business world, if you can just follow this, you will find that you're always happier, and don't reprimand your staff for the result. Okay, you can actually coach them and guide them on the action that they can take. Remember, the results are not directly under their control. And treat every employee like how you will treat the number one client of you. If you can treat the server, the waiter, the watchman, like the way you treat the number one client, okay, that is where you are actually going to treat everyone. So respect yourself, respect everyone in the same way as equal human beings, they will start falling in love with you, Piyush, and they will never leave you. Okay, so just give equal respect to everyone and treat them like equal, and they will always be with you till the end of their life with you.
Ganesh is saying, early in the morning, the bird will fly a long way. True or not?
Obviously, I wake up early in the morning. I have a long day to work, no? I actually, by around 11 o'clock, my whole day is done. All my businesses are taken care. I have a lot of time today. I watch one movie a day. I write 200 pages a day. So I have enough time. That's the reason early in the morning, you have a long haul. You can actually do a lot of things in your life.
Okay, Mohit is saying, how can happiness formula work on a person whose past thing is giving trouble in person? How to overcome?
This is where many of us don't understand. Whatever has happened in the past is happened. Right now, do not bring the past residue to the present moment right now. This is where the monkey mind plays an amazing trick by bringing the past images into the current moment. Remember, only once it has happened in your real life, but many of us keep on replaying the thing again and again and again, and we blow out of the whole proportion in our mind. And you know, there is a very unique research says that if you keep on thinking three times more same thing again and again, a traumatic experience, it goes into your cellular memory level, and that stays inside your cellular memory also, then it is very difficult to remove that out of you. So that's the reason why past is past. Can you change anything? You cannot go back and change the past because we don't have a time machine to go back. There is no one has invented a time machine to go back into the past, Mohit. All you need, you have to understand and accept. Many of them don't accept the past because they have not accepted the past incidences in their life. That's the reason it's giving you trouble in the present, because you have not accepted. You have not closed that chapter of yesterday. You are carrying yesterday to today. Once you go to sleep, yesterday's chapter is over. That's it. You should not revisit. And you need to start practicing this in your life every day. Yesterday is over. I will not bring yesterday to today. Today is a fresh day. Today is 86,400 new seconds of my life. I will lead today only in the right way. I will not bring yesterday to today. I will learn what I learned from yesterday's experience, but not the memory of yesterday to today. Because every experience is going to teach you something. Just grab the learning and see to that you don't repeat those mistakes in your life. I hope that answered your question, Mohit.
Can I add something to it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. What I consider past is a lesson, and take the corrective action in the present. Past is just a lesson. So when you see it as a lesson, you will feel better. I believe that. Okay. Silish is asking, how to stay positive and happy even when you are absolutely negative situation, whether it is a family or workspace, especially when you are the person who always want to stay positive and who wanted to hear positive things.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely, Silas. The whole family will be negative only. Okay. You mean to say that no, there are situations where you can't get rid of your family. That's okay. We can't do anything, but don't try to change them. They are like that. Let them be like that. If they are negative, don't try to go and change them. Only when you try to change them, give them the gyan, give them that lecture to them to bring positive, that's where you're inviting trouble. You just stay happy. You do your work. Ignore them. You will always find happiness within you, because we cannot change anyone in the world. The only person who has control, only thing that you have control is your thoughts that are flowing in your head. That also you can't control the thought. We have only one choice, whether to pick this thought or not pick this thought. That's all you have, the only control in the whole world itself. So just be positive, just stay and ignore whether the family members are negative and all. You can't change them. Just leave them as they are, accept them as they are, and you just lead your happy things. And probably one fine day when your happiness is very high, it may rub off to them and they may become happier one day.
Okay, thank you. Our next question is from Anthony Vijay. Is only yoga can help you get positive mindset in everyday life?
No. There are multiple methods are there to give you the positive mindset. Okay, for example, going for an exercise, walking, running, gymming. that also gives you a lot of happy hormones and chemicals inside the body. Okay. For some people, only when they flex the body by doing various activities, they actually get more positive. For some people, probably they have to read some intellectual books. They have to read some positive self-development books or attend seminars or webinars like this. Thereby, their mind becomes positive. Yoga is one methodology. It's not the only thing. Some people, they have to do prayer. Only when they pray with full devotion and faith to the Lord, then they actually become happier. For some people, they want to do various other activities. Some people, they want to go and serve the society. They will go to their temple or mosque or church and they do seva over there. And through service, they actually find their happiness and positivism. So there is no one methodology to become more positive and happier. Again, it will vary from human beings to human beings. You need to explore and find which method gives you that happiness. Once you figure out, do that until it gives you happiness. And once one day it stops giving you happiness, go to the next one. Because every day is going to change.
Okay, Rohit is asking, I get solution for my problem during my sleep. Is it normal activity?
You know, Einstein used to have a notebook and pen when he goes to sleep. Because suddenly he wakes up from his sleep, he gets a lot of formulas and he writes. And it's a very unique science. Actually, in the workshop which I teach in the one day, I actually very go into the science of sleeping and what actually happens in the sleep and why are we able to solve many problems in the sleep itself. Rohit, it's quite normal activity, Rohit. It happens with many, many people. You are just aware when you woke up that some problem solution you got. Many of them keep practicing. They keep on thinking about one problem and they go to sleep. When they wake up in the morning, they got a solution. They got an inspiration to take action and they got relieved from the problem. So it's very normal, Rohit.
Vinod is asking, any simple technique to handle human relationship and emotion, especially with the opposite gender?
You need to read a book called Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus by John Gray, who tells you how human men and women are different in their expectation itself. Okay, so if you want to handle the opposite gender, for example, women, all they need is attention and respect. Okay, if you can just handle these two, give attention and respect, that's the fastest way to build relationship. Okay, and you have to pay attention to them. And when they ask you something, they're not asking you for solution. Please remember, don't try to give solution. Just pay attention. Whatever they say, just listen to them. That's all they are looking out for. Similarly, men expects a lot of respect and credit. Men are a little egoistic, so they expect respect. And they always want credit to whatever they say for. So if you are a woman, how do you deal with a man? It's very simple. Give them their credit that you are the best. Because of you only, this is happening. And give them the respect, you will actually easier to handle opposite gender. And treat everyone equally with respect, you will find husband and wife relationship happens very smoothly. And there should not be any ego barrier over there. Treat everyone equal, it becomes easier. So if you really want to understand more, read this book. You will really enjoy this one book called Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus. You will love handling human relationship with that.
Okay, Anish is asking, after jogging, do we need to keep time gap for doing breathing exercise?
No need. You can, after coming out of jogging, you just come and sit in one place and start doing breathing exercise because it cools down the whole body. It also becomes your relaxation, post-exercise relaxation activity also. So you can immediately do also, nothing wrong with that.
Anish have another question. One of his friend who's in his company is always sad. He's always thinking he's a fool. Some of his friends treat him as a comic character and he felt so bad about that. How can we overcome this?
He only has to overcome it. We can't do anything for him. So he has to have that, that desire, that burning desire to come out of this. Right now, he is finding a little bit of pity, happiness inside when he gets insulted by others. So he needs to get that drive to get out of that situation. And whenever he's ready, just take him to any NLP coach or NLP therapist. They will quickly, in 30 minutes, they can actually change the whole mentality of him. Or take him to any psychologist or any kind of counselor. Immediately, they can uplift him. Or just ask him to attend any one of Tony Robbins' seminar. Immediately, he will come out of the whole thing itself.
Okay,
how many questions are there? Wow.
One more. That's the last one.
Okay. I hope everyone is still enjoying this Q&A. Many of them. Okay.
Lakshmi is asking, suppose both the husband and wife start to ignore each other and being happy themselves, don't you think it will affect the whole family life? This is an add-on to question by Silesh earlier about negative family. So this is just add-on.
When husband and wife are happier in their own way, okay, they will never affect the other person's happiness at all. Okay, the husband is happier, the wife is happier, the family will always be happy because they are not thinking anything bad for each other. So it's a paradoxical question that you've asked. If the husband and wife start ignoring each other, okay, so if they ignore each other, they are actually creating conflict and tension within us. And they are trying to bury the problem instead of confronting the whole problem itself. Okay. So it means you are just avoiding a problem to solve and you want to stay happier. Okay. So it means you are inviting trouble for a parting gift with each other. So best is you need to sit, discuss, resolve it, because any problem between husband and wife can be resolved just with an open, honest communication. If they can sit, drop their ego, with the attitude to resolve the problem, they can always resolve. If they are holding their ego, both the sides, and if they want to prove the other side wrong, then nothing can be done. I am wrong. I am right. You are wrong. If you have that particular attitude, then happiness will never come. They literally destroy not only their happiness, they destroy the whole family's happiness also.
Okay. Can I add something to it?
Go ahead.
I love negative people from a distance. Love them from a distance. I keep negative people away and love them from a distance. So one last question was there from Silesh. How to get rid of procrastination and laziness?
Oh, only by taking action. By taking action, you can get rid of procrastination and laziness. Find out what is causing you laziness. What is making you to do the procrastination? Many of them are procrastinating is because that's one biggest disease many of them have in today's world, because they are not excited in doing things what they are doing. They do not have that burning purpose to help a lot of people. They are only thinking about themselves. If you have a larger purpose which can benefit the humanity, you will never procrastinate because you have a lot of things to do. You will be always a man of action. One action after another action after another action. You will not have time even for laziness at all. So Silesh, the easiest way to get rid of procrastination is come up with a very big goal which you yourself are literally scared. Okay, fix that goal. Create a purpose in your life and start working on it. You will get rid of procrastination. I actually have a separate course in my Unlimited Happiness itself, how to get rid of anti-procrastination itself. There are varieties of techniques are there. This is one particular technique of setting a big purpose and goal in life.
Okay, that was the last question. Thank you, Murali Sundaram.
My pleasure. For spending
your valuable time over here. Okay, for the participants over here, if you learned something from Murali Sundaram, type yes in the chat box. Let me see. Okay. Come on, guys. We have about 100 people over here. Okay. So everyone has learned something. So would you like to have a gift from Murali Sundaram? Would you like to have a gift? If yes, say yes. Okay, so here is a link I'm sharing right now. Yeah, thank you for all your response. Right now I'll be sharing a link. Go to the link. There's a free session and free lot of stuff over there. Go subscribe to it right away. So here's the link.
Thank you.
Come on, action takers, right now. Go right now and do it, not later. Don't be a procrastinator right now.
Priya Chandran is asking what happened to the lift technique, which I covered long back. Hey, Priya, I already communicated the lift technique. Don't read newspaper and TV.
I'll post the link once again. Please go to the link and subscribe to the...
Or they can go to happinesscourse.com also.
Yeah.
Anyone. They can receive the daily... happiness lessons every single
day. Amazing letters we get in the mail. Key. So with this, would you like to add something to it?
I think that's an amazing conference. The amazing thing that you're doing, Abhishek, to motivate everyone, to inspire everyone. So very good gesture that you're doing. So please do continue this good effort in motivating everyone, because these are the times where we need a little bit of inspiration and motivation, and the mind needs to be kept motivated and calm. So you're doing an amazing thing. So please do continue. And I think every day you are having some conference, I believe. So all the very best. And Vidushi is amazing in helping you to create content, because ultimately this is the time where you can actually sit and write a lot of content for your own business and get your business ready for once the lockdown is opened up. Okay. So all the very best, Yapshad and the Business Success Conference team for this amazing, amazing effort, and have a fantastic evening. And thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to come and share my experience with each one of you. I hope everyone enjoyed, and thank you very much, and good night to everyone.
Thank you so much for being here. There is a Facebook group and WhatsApp group. Everyone can join those groups. All the speakers will be there in the Facebook group and the WhatsApp group. If you want to learn more from them, you can contact them through the Facebook group and the WhatsApp group. And tomorrow, we have Creating Quality Content for Quality Leads by Vidushi. Please do attend it. Same time, 8:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time. Till then, bye-bye. This is Yapshad Kiki, engineering graduate who turned into serial entrepreneur and to a business coach. Thank you. Good night.